Now, KMGH 7 News.
Good afternoon. One of Denver's most popular newspaper columnists and Channel 7 commentator, John Coit, died early this morning of a heart attack. He was 38 years old. John is survived by his wife, Susan, and three children. The funeral is scheduled for 9 a.m. Wednesday at the Holy Ghost Catholic Church downtown. John's body will then be shipped to Arlington National Cemetery in Virginia for burial. The family suggests donations to Denver's Good Samaritan shelter in lieu of flowers. Now, Channel 7 anchor Jim Redmond was a very close friend to John Coit. He has more on a man who touched all of us.
There he was, just 11 days ago, his life finally put back together, smiles everywhere, and friends from every walk of life at his wedding. He'd been a shipwreck of a man when I first met him, a refugee from a heart-wrenching divorce and breakup of his family in North Carolina. Like so many before, seeking a new life in the great American West. It's hard to believe he was only in Denver about 2.5 years. The first was a great struggle against depression and the temptation John had just to drop out. Maybe that struggle to get his life back together was why he had so much empathy for the street people down on Larimer, the droogs he called them. He never wondered how they ended up there. He knew, having nearly crossed into the half-light of their world himself. We used to talk a lot about how you cope, how fortune is a blind god. Sometimes the rain falls, but sometimes sunshine too. I guess he saw in me what he wanted so badly for himself, stability, a long-lasting family relationship. I was drawn to the big bear of a man because he never fretted over little things like being late. And he always accepted people for what they are and was never judgmental about the way others use or abuse their lives. John Coit was always laughing on the outside, a real kick in the pants. But inside, the cauldron often boiled over with frustration and insecurity. He'd been getting it all together. The column, one of the most read parts of the Rocky, his television pieces drawing lots of positive comment, and his relationship with Susan growing into the kind of thing where two people can say to each other,
I, John, take you, Susan.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I, Susan, take you, John.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
As I watched them marry 11 days ago, I caught myself thinking, I hope this works, knowing that this time it would. For John Coit had learned the most important lesson of the human experience that the great English preacher John Donne wrote about in 1624, a lesson that was my first thought after the phone rang this morning and my heart skipped a beat. No man is an island entire of itself. Every man is a piece of the continent, a part of the main. If a clod be washed away by the sea, Europe is the less, as well as if a promontory were, as well as if a manor of thy friends or of thine own were. Any man's death diminishes me, because I am involved in mankind.
Time it was, and what a time it was, a time of innocence, a time of confidences. Long ago, it must be, I have a photograph. Preserve your memories, they're all that's left you.
John Coit is now a photograph left for us behind. A man having the time of his life at his wedding on New Year's Eve, dancing with the Kim Chicken. A man who turned it all around and touched us deeply, and then was called away. Vaya con Dios, mi amigo.
We are all going to miss John very much.